Hi all, today we can see the numericals based on Newton's ring. In Newton's ring, mainly the problems are based on the diameter of the ring. The diameter of the ring expression is d square m equal to 4m r lambda, where m is the order, r is the radius of curvature of the lens, lambda is the wavelength of light used. If the diameter corresponding to two rings are given, we can use the formula d square m plus p minus d square m is equal to 4p r lambda. Now we can see the first question. In Newton's ring experiment, the diameter of 10th darker ring due to wavelength 6000 angstrom in air is 0.5 cm. Find the radius of curvature of lens. In Newton's ring experiment, diameter of 10th darker ring, so D10 is equal to 0.5 cm due to the wavelength of light, that is lambda is equal to 6000 angstrom. In air, so the medium refractive index is 1. Find the radius of curvature of the lens. So we can use the formula d square m is equal to 4 m r lambda. So radius of curvature r is equal to d square m divided by 4 m lambda, that is 0.5 square divided by 4 into 10th dark ring, so m equal to 10 into 6000 angstrom, so 6000 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. If we are not converting the centimeter into meter, we can write it as 6000 into 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter, that is equal to 104 centimeter. Second question, in a Newton's ring experiment, diameter of 15th ring was found to be 0.59 cm and that of 5th ring was 0.336 cm. If the radius of plano-convex lens is 100 cm, calculate wavelength of light used. So first we can write the data. Diameter of 15th ring was found to be 0.59 cm. So D15 is equal to 0.59 cm and that of the 5th ring was 0.336 cm. If the radius of plano-convex lens is 100 cm, calculate the wavelength of light used. So which formula we have to use? There are two diameters corresponding to two orders. So we can use the formula d square m plus p minus d square m is equal to 4p r lambda. So what is the p here? P is equal to 15 minus 5. This is dm plus p, this is dm, and p is equal to 15 minus 5, that is equal to 10. So from this formula we can write the lambda as d square m plus p minus d square m divided by 4 p r. This D15 corresponding to dm plus p and D5 corresponding to dm. So dm plus p square is 0.59 square minus dm square is 0.336 square divided by 4 into p is 10 into radius of curvature is 100. That is equal to 5.88 into 10 raised to minus 5 centimeter. Here everything we have written in centimeter only. So that is 5880 into 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter. So 10 raised to minus 8 centimeter is 1 angstrom. So that means answer is 5880 angstrom is the wavelength of light used. See the next question. In a Newton's ring experiment, the diameter of 4th and 12th dark rings are 0.400 cm and 0.7 cm respectively. Determine diameter of 20th dark ring. The diameter of 4th and 12th dark ring, that is D4 and D12, are given as 0.4 cm and 0.7 cm respectively. We want to find out the diameter of the 20th dark ring. So to find the diameter of any ring, we required that radius of curvature and wavelength of light, both are not given. Using these two diameters and this expression, we can write it as D12 square minus D4 square is equal to 4 into P. That is, if you are considering 12th and 4th ring, P is equal to 12 minus 4, that is 8, into R lambda, equation number 1. Now we can consider the 20th ring and 4th ring. then what will be the expression? D20 square minus D4 square is equal to 4 into 20 minus 4 will be the p value there. That is 16 into r lambda. That is equation number 2. Now we can divide both these equations 1 by 2. That is D12 square minus D4 square divided by D20 square minus D4 square is equal to 1 by 2. Now we can substitute the data. D12 is 0.7 square minus D4 is 0.4 square divided by D20 square minus D4 square is 0.4 square is equal to 1 by 2. And on cross multiplying, D20 square minus 0.4 square is equal to 2 into, on calculating this we will get 0.33. So, D20 square is equal to 2 into 0.33, that is 0.66 plus 0.4 square, that is 0.16. So, that is equal to 0.82. So, the diameter of the 20th ring will be the square root of 0.82, that is 0.906 centimeter. So, the next question. In a Newton's ring experiment, diameter of 10th ring changes from 1.40 to 1.27 cm when a drop of liquid is introduced between the lens and glass plate. Find the refractive index of liquid. The diameter of 10th ring changes from 1.40 to 1.27. So, the diameter of the 10th ring in air is 1.40 and in liquid it is 1.27. So, we want to find out the refractive index of liquid. So, we can use the expression, the square of the diameter of mth ring in liquid is equal to square of that diameter in air divided by refractive index of the liquid. So, refractive index of the liquid is equal to square of the diameter in air divided by that of liquid. So, in air the diameter is 1.40 square divided by, in liquid it is 1.27 square. On calculating this we will get it as 1.215. So, the refractive index of the liquid is 1.215. Next question. In Newton's ring experiment, dark ring due to wavelength 4800 angstrom coincide with the dark ring due to wavelength 6000 angstrom and no other wavelength in between. If the radius of curvature of curved surface of the lens is 0.96 meter and the refractive index of medium is 1.2, calculate radius of the dark ring. In this question, two wavelengths are given. One is 4800 angstrom and the second wavelength is 6000 angstrom. The dark ring due to this wavelength 1 coincide with the dark ring due to this second wavelength and there is no other wavelength in between them. If the radius of curvature of the lens is 0.96 meter and the refractive index of the medium is 1.2, calculate the radius of the dark ring. So, we don't know what is the order of that ring. So, first we have to find out the order of that ring. Then we can substitute this formula and can find out the diameter and hence radius of the ring. So, our aim is to find out the order. To find out the order, one condition they are given that the dark ring due to these two wavelengths are coinciding and there is no other wavelength in between them. What is the condition for darkness in Newton's ring? 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda. So, for Newton's ring, cos r is equal to 1 because we are considering normal incidence of light. So, cos r is equal to 1. So, this expression becomes 2 mu t is equal to m lambda. The dark ring due to this lambda 1 and lambda 2 coincides. So, that meaning is that 2 mu t is equal to m1 lambda 1 and also 2 mu t is equal to m2 lambda 2. Here m1 corresponding to the wavelength lambda 1 and m2 corresponds to the wavelength lambda 2. Also, it is given that there is no other wavelength in between them. That is, one order will correspond to m, then the second order will be m plus 1. So, which one is corresponding to m and m plus 1? Small order will corresponding to high wavelength and a higher order will corresponding to low wavelength. That is, m will corresponding to the high wavelength, which is that 6000 angstrom, and this 4800 angstrom will corresponding to m plus 1th order. So in equation 1 and 2 we can substitute this condition, that is m1 lambda 1 is equal to m2 lambda 2. So m1 is wave order corresponding to lambda 1. So lambda 1 is 4800 angstrom, that is corresponding to m plus 1. So m plus 1 into 4800 angstrom is equal to m into lambda 2 is 6000 angstrom. On solving this, we will get 4m plus 4 is equal to 5m, or we can write it as m is equal to 4. Now we got the order m as 4, so we can find out the diameter of the fourth ring using the formula 4m r lambda. Here the refractive index mu is also given, so we have to consider that also, divided by mu. So d 4 square is equal to 4 into 4 into radius of curvature is 0.96 meter into wavelength lambda. This m corresponding to the wavelength is 6000 angstrom. So 6000 into 10 raised to minus 10. Here also we considered meter, divided by refractive index is 1.2. So on calculating and taking the square root, we will get the diameter of the fourth ring as 4 into 69.28 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. So radius of this fourth ring is half of this diameter, that is 138.56 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. Okay, or we can write it as 0.138 centimeter. So in the question, if the dark ring due to two wavelengths are coinciding, we can write it as 2 mu t equal to m1 lambda 1 and 2 mu t equal to m2 lambda 2. And if there is no wavelength in between them, the order corresponds to m and a m plus 1. The m corresponds to the high wavelength and m plus 1 corresponding to the low wavelength. One last question. In Newton's ring experiment, dark ring due to wavelength of 7500 angstrom coincided with the dark ring due to wavelength of 5000 angstrom and no other wavelength in between. If the diameter of overlapping ring is 0.5 cm and refractive index of medium is 1.33, calculate the radius of curvature of the lens. So in this question, two wavelengths are given. Lambda 1 is equal to 7500 angstrom and lambda 2 is equal to 5000 angstrom. So they are coinciding each other. So if the diameter of the overlapping ring is 0.5 cm and refractive index of the medium is 1.33, find the radius of curvature of the lens. Here the dark ring due to these two wavelengths are coinciding, and it is also given that there is no other wavelength in between them. That means it will corresponding to the order m and m plus 1. So which one will corresponding to the order m? That is, smaller wavelength will corresponding to higher order and higher wavelength will corresponding to smaller order. So this will corresponding to m, and 5000 angstrom will corresponding to m plus 1. We know the darkness condition, that is 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda, and for Newton's ring cos r is equal to 1 because of normal incidence. So 2 mu t is equal to m lambda. Since these dark rings are coinciding, we can say m1 lambda 1 is equal to m2 lambda 2. So lambda 1 is 7500 angstrom, that corresponding to the order m is equal to lambda 2 is 5000 angstrom, that corresponding to the order m plus 1. So that is, this is 2, 3. On solving, we will get 3m is equal to 2m plus 2, or m is equal to 2. That is, the order corresponds to 2, the second dark ring we are considering here. So the diameter of that second dark ring is given as 0.5 cm. So what is the expression for the diameter of the mth ring? That is 4m r lambda divided by mu. What we want to find out? The radius of curvature. So the expression for radius of curvature is d square m mu divided by 4m lambda. That is, the diameter of mth ring is 0.5 centimeter, 0.5 into 10 raised to minus 2, into refractive index is 1.33, divided by 4 into m is 2, into wavelength lambda. That is, the wavelength corresponding to the order m. So, the wavelength corresponding to order m is 7500 Armstrong, that is 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So, it is equal to 5.9 meter. So, the radius of curvature of the given lens is 5.9 meter. So, you try more questions. All the best.